We left the Blue Mountains of Sydney, headed northwards to Newcastle, then turned inland, arriving at the Watagans Forest not too long after. It's a beautiful mixture of dry woodland as well as beautiful lush old-growth rainforest. Phil couldn't contain himself. I opened the door and out he went. The Watagans is an amazing place full of all sorts of different frogs. We walked down one of the tracks and I spotted something very interesting clinging to a rock wall. It's a leaf-tailed gecko, but Phil saw something on the ground pretty much right next to it.
Oh my God, I've just come across my first giant barred frog. I am over the moon. I've been waiting to see one of these since I got to Australia. I haven't had the chance, I haven't been in the right part of Australia at the right time. And this is the start of the breeding season here in New South Wales. And what a find. Huge, the size of your hand. Massive thing with a massive mouth. They eat all the frogs, they'll take small snakes, big insects. Look at the colour of its eyes, unreal. Look at the patterning, incredible. I'm made up.
Sitting on the leaf litter in the middle of the track was a remarkable species of frog I'd always wanted to see. Now this frog here is a black-soled or sandpaper frog. True to the name, their skin is rough like sandpaper, but it's also very toxic. That's not all. The very fact this one has made it to adulthood means it's got a very dark little secret indeed. Okay. It's in small forest pools like this one that this remarkable frog story begins. At the start, the breeding habits of the black-soled frog are fairly standard. Pairs lay eggs in forest pools in foam nests which soon break up as the eggs hatch. But the thing about the forest pools is the nutrient levels and the food supply are very, very low. And that's where things get really bizarre. But we'll have to save that for another time. The next morning, we headed back into the forest to check out the tracks once more.
Putting your finger or hand in any burrow or hole is not the best idea in the bush. We've just spotted one now. We're not sure what's in it. It looks like a tarantula's burrow. So I'm gonna try with this inanimate object. Yes, oh, he's really bit onto that then. That's exactly why you don't want to be putting your finger in. You've got no idea what it is, but a stick, you can have a good look, see what it is, and stay safe.
The frog at the top of my list is a beautiful Blue Mountains tree frog. We're lucky enough to not only see them, but actually film one calling. On the way back to camp, we spotted something awesome running across the road.
Look at that, what a spider that is. I can't believe me luck, I've never seen one of these. I'm just driving through Watagans National Park and just seen it crossing the road and just dived out straight out after it. I'd feel safe enough to actually hold the thing, I don't think, you know. But why take a chance?
Well, it's been a rather interesting day today. We left our campsite up at Watagans State Forest and we've been driving all the way out to here in Gloucester. The heavens opened up and we discovered that the roof of my car was leaking. So quite a bit of effort, wasn't it, Phil?
Sure was.
Yeah, went to the mechanics, had it worrying, checking the seals, blasting out the drainage holes with air compressor, took half of the upholstery out of the roof to put it back in again, but we're back on track, only 4 hours late.
Are you filming there?